So today is the 26th of January 2021. It is 4 p.m. So we consider the dissertation count medal for the defense of the dissertation by Paul Aleksandrovich Kuryndin on completion of scientific degree of candidate of judicial scientist in specialization 12.0014, administrative law, administrative procedure, pre-trial appeal of actions and inaction or decision of administrative bodies, experience of Russia and trials be considered open. By order of St. Petersburg State University, on the 27th of December 2020, number 9579/1, I, Sergei Dmitrievich Knyazev, Doctor of Legal Scientist, the Honored Lawyer of Russia, Honorable Worker of Science of Russian Federation, Professor of Department of Administrative and Financial Law of St. Petersburg, Judge of Constitutional Court of the Russian Chupi, was appointed Chairman of the Dissertation. Let me introduce the members of the Dissertation Council. Astafyev, Pavel Aleksandrovich, Doctor of Law, Professor of the Department of Constitutional and International Law of St. Petersburg University and the Ministry of Internal Affairs of the Russian Federation. In remote access mode, we have Vinitsky Andrei, Doctor of Law, Professor of the Department of Administrative Law, Head of the Department of Land, Urban Planning and Environment Law, World State Law University. Elvira Talapina, Doctor of Law, Chief Researcher of the Institute of State of the Russian Academy of Sciences. Vladimir Yarkov, Professor, Honored Scientist of Russian Federation, Head of the Department of Civil Procedures of Ural State University. Grigory Vasilevich, Doctor of Law, Professor, Corresponding Member of the National Academy of Sciences of Belarus, Head of the Department of Constitutional Law of the Law Faculty of the Belarusian State University. Dear colleagues, those who are in the remote access mode, can you hear us? Can you see us? Please testify to that. We can see and hear you. Thank you. Everything's fine. The applicant himself is present. Also, the meeting in the of the dissertation council in the remote mode has the scientific advisor, Yelena Gritsenko, PhD, Legal Sciences, Professor of the Department of Constitutional Law of St. Petersburg State University. I can see Yelena Vladimirovna. In order to improve the quality of communication, I ask you, dear colleagues, those who are in the remote mode, to turn off your microphones when you're not speaking, but please do not forget to turn them on when you're given the floor. I also inform you that audio and video recording of our meeting is being carried out, and there is live broadcast on St. Petersburg State University website. Also, consecutive interpretation is provided from Russian to English and vice versa. There is an email address on the website which can be accessed by all those who listen to the defense and send their questions online. Those questions related to the thesis and the scientific discussion of the presentation. The technical service will send it to the chairperson and I will voice them. All the questions are to be related to the presentation of the applicant. They need to provide the reference to the name and surname and the position and the place of work. Those questions are not related to the thesis and not to related to the issues discussed in the thesis will not be voiced. In accordance with the procedure of awarding the academic degree of candidate of science, academic degree of Doctor of Science of St. Petersburg State University, approved by local regulations of St. Petersburg State University, a meeting of the Dissertation Council is considered competent if at least two-thirds of the approved number of members take place. Our dissertation council consists of six people. All six are present, including four members in the remote access mode. All the dissertation council and the applicant are provided with audiovisual contact. Thus, we have a quorum. I establish the following rule of procedure for today's meeting of the Dissertation Council meeting, total duration of approximately 2 hours. Brief report of the chairman on the documents submitted by the applicant for scientific degree and their compliance with the established requirements. Answers to possible questions, about 5 minutes. Short presentation by the applicant for scientific degree, reflecting the main points of the research, approximately 15 minutes. Question to the applicant strictly according to the report, no more than 2 minutes per question. Answers of the applicant to the question, no more than 10 minutes. For everything. Statement, speeches of all the members of the Dissertation Council in turn with their assessment of the dissertation research and the presentation of the applicant with a summary on the petition and question suggestions for the dissertation, approximately 10 minutes per speaker. Speech by the chairman with the assessment of the dissertation search, approximately 10 minutes. Answers of the applicant for a scientific degree to questions and comments of the members of the Dissertation Council, no more than 20 minutes. Open discussion, speeches at the request of those present at the defense with a summary of the position or specific questions or proposal for the applicant strictly on the topic of the research, no more than 2 minutes per speaker. At the same time, we ask everyone to register in the registration form and introduce themselves, give name, surname, and the position. The submission of the questions to the applicant, which came in order, which came through email via the broadcast of the meeting of the Station Council. Applicants' answers to those questions. Presentation by the supervisor of the applicant in more than 3 minutes. Discussion by the members of the Dissertation Council before the open vote of the results of the defense. And if necessary, dear colleagues, during our discussion, if it is required, the sound will be muted. And it will last for about 2 minutes, of course, if we need it, once again. Open roll call, counting of votes by the chairman of the Dissertation Council with the entry of the results in the minutes of the meeting, making decision on whether toward or not toward an academic degree, and the final word of the applicant. Dear colleagues, are there any questions or objections to the rules of procedure? If there are no objections, we'll try to comply with the rules of procedure. Now we move on then to the meeting itself and to the implementation of the rules of the procedure. First of all, I would like to remind you that it's necessary to mute the sound. Thank you for understanding. So we are starting the meeting. The thesis of Kuryndin Pavel Aleksandrovich for the degree of candidate of legal sciences in the major administrative law, administrative procedure, pre-trial appeal of action and action or decision, administrative books, experience of Russia, France. Accepted for defense by order of the Academic Secretary of Petersburg State University, number 9440/1, dated October 2020. Kuryndin Pavel made the thesis on the basis of St. Petersburg State University. The scientific advisor is Doctor of Law, Professor of Constitutional Law, St. Petersburg State University, Yelena Gritsenko. The number of publications of the articles which set the basic scientific results of the dissertation, according to the list of three works. In peer-reviewed scientific journals from the list approved by the Ministry of Education of the Russian Federation, three publications. In publication indexed in sinometric databases such as Web Science and Scopus, no publications. The applicant submitted to the scientific sanctuary in St. Petersburg State University a complete package of four documents for acceptance for consideration and defense of the thesis, all documents corresponding to clause 12, section 3 of the procedure. All the documents provided by the applicant, according to the information they received from the curator, meet the requirements and are kept in the attestation file. The copies are obtained by the Department for Support of the Dissertation Council, and the officers of the department are present. Before giving the floor to the applicant, I would like to ask you, dear members of the Dissertation Council, if you have any general question to the applicants, including whether there is a need to announce and consider the entire list of documents submitted by the applicants for defense. As far as I understand, there is no such necessity. Thank you. Then we move on to the defense. And I give the floor to Pavel Aleksandrovich for a short presentation. Thank you very much for the floor. Good afternoon, esteemed Sergei Dmitrievich and the members of the Dissertation Council. Allow me to present the main provisions and conclusions from my research. The relevance of the topic of the research is due to the task of the modern stage of development of administrative law, which is development in the light of the state service and participative society. Under the aegis of digitalization, administrative procedures, and electronic interaction, thus strengthening the role of Russia in the global information space. This all leads to the search for an efficient mechanism of protection of rights and freedoms. Thus, pre-trial appeal might be considered as such a way, since it is a reduced form, but at the same time, the applicant might get the final decision this way much faster than within the framework of a court appeal. At the same time, pre-court appeal faces the situation that the legislative regulation is not always coherent. For example, we have the law on the procedure for considering appeals of citizens of the Russian Federation, which is in force. But this law guarantees receiving the response within a month. There are no other guarantees stipulated by the laws, or these gaps cannot be bridged by other existing law. For example, federal law on provision of public service, or federal law on state control, municipal control in the Russian Federation. For these legislative acts are directed at the spheres according to which they work. Taking into account that the Russian law operates in a non-isolated way and is a part of international context, the level of the development of the Russian legal theory can be combined with the foreign expertise. A special place among these practice is occupied by France, and French experience is important for a number of reasons. Firstly, it has comprehensive administrative traditions. The French state law was formulated in accordance with the State Council, some of which date back to the second half of the 19th century. In addition, the French administrative law operates in a multi-level legal system, including supranational and international level. What is more, French experience is of interest since there is a unified law on administrative procedure which settles a pre-trial dispute. The aim of the study is the following. First of all, I identify the problems arising in the process of pretrial appeals, formulation of possible way to solve them, a definition of conceptual ideas for the development of the institution, and elimination of existing legislative gaps and contradictions. Since we do not have a unified approach to solution of certain legal aspects, we need to formulate all the possible ways taken into account of solutions taken into account foreign experience. In order to achieve the stated goals, there are several main tasks, which include comparative analysis of administrative legal system of Russian France to identify common and specific features of pretrial appeal. Also, it was necessary to determine the relationship of pretrial and judicial appeal of actions in France and Russia, to assess the applicability of the French experience in Russian conditions, since French practice allows us to say that they are more advanced if we compare it to the Russian conditions. Also, I identified my own approach to certain terms and definitions which did not have a unified definition. These include rehomatia impeus, good governance doctrine. The scientific novelty of the work consists in the following. I conducted systematic study of specific elements of the institution of pretrial appeal of action. This is the notion of complaint, the guarantees of individuals, terms, and interim measures. I talked about the legal categories of administrative act and the doctrine of good governance and implicit decision theory that can be attributed to the Russian realia. Thus, a mechanism of improvement of the situation in the pretrial appeal system might be conducted. Taking into account the review of all the terms and concept, I provided a personalized idea. The provision for defense are the following. It seems that the increase of the efficiency of the Institute of Pretrial Appeal is possible with adopting of unified administrative procedures law, which might solve certain problems, such as terminology unification, since some laws have different terminology. Also, sectoral law has a different approach to the issues of counting the term, the procedure, the final steps of providing the information to the applicant. Another important provision and is the definition of administrative act as an object of pretrial appeal. The universal features of administrative act are its individual and specific nature. A specific application is the basis for the emergence of specific rights and obligations of individual actor to whom this act is addressed. Such an act can be both burdensome or favorable or beneficial. At the same time, the form of an act in France is not always considered by administrative theory and practice as a defining feature. The main thing that is assessed is whether the rights and freedoms, in case specified by the law, of an individual are violated or affected. And in this sense, a telegram can be recognized as an administrative act. Thus, legitimate form of administrative act in Russia should not be an obstacle to its pretrial appeal. For example, the administrative body actually refuses the applicant sending a letter of unclear contest. Thus, the proceeding cannot be completed, since another body did not provide the necessary information. The courts do not always try to directly assess the so-called refusal letters, but they are looking for the formal grounds to check the legality of administrative acts. In accordance to the published statistics, there are also cases when administrative bodies do not provide any information. if we have a look at the statistics at the Seropol Regional Court, there are about 15 cases which are related to violation of the term for consideration and complaints. Thus, the applicant does not get any decision or any information on the decision taken. Thus, the time limit for getting the response is important. Thus, I consider that individuals might benefit from the French doctrine of implicit solutions. It means that the lack of response from the administrative body might mean either decision against or decision for, depending on the type of the body. But the most importantly is that the applicant gets the information from the administrative body. The right to pre-trial appeal of administrative acts in France is an element of the right to good governance. The core of the right has three aspects. The aspect and the right to be heard, the request familiarization with the case materials, and to be provided evidence if necessary. But in practice, in Russia, when an individual makes a complaint, the private actor cannot influence on the decision taken as such. The administrative body provides the final result, and the private actor cannot influence the final decision. Thus, the good governance doctrine might help to neutralize the negative aspects of this procedural aspect. These might be considered the minimum standards for a fair trial. Also, I'd like to add that when considering protocols of administrative offenses by officials, it is necessary to make it possible for the person responsible for the passing the judgment and the perpetrator be present. Thus, the classification of the offense might be conducted at a more right level, and the punishment might be mitigated. What is more, there is in Russia there is juxtaposition of the two approaches of protecting rights and freedoms of the citizens. In France, the Council of States links both methods, such as judicial practice and pre-trial proceedings. This approach has a unified goal. They are aimed at judicial extinguishment of an illegal act. Thus, using French experience in Russia might result in good possibility of a settling dispute. Thus, these approaches might be viewed as having one common goal. The last provision for defense is a relationship between the pretrial and judicial stages of administrative act appeal. If we talk about administrative bodies, it should be noted that administrative bodies are competent to review the case in essence, not to consider it not from the point of view of legality, but also from expediency. But we have the separation of powers, and the court cannot interfere in the executive power. But these specific trait of public area say that we need to assess the expediency of such an action depending on the type of administrative act, whether it corresponds to the letter and spirit of the law. And French methodology views the possibility of appraisal of the goals and motives depending on the administrative acts. and limited control is provided only for the acts. For example, when a private actor sent some documents and got a refusal, and then the court checks whether the judicial classification of the situation was conducted. The control is exercised in order to check the discretion of the necessary acts. Only if private freedom is violated, such as non-possibility to publish foreign media information. Thus, this methodology stipulates that Russian practice might be implemented, French practice might be implemented in Russia, since Russian practice has limited positivistic approach. Maybe these are the general provisions in accordance with the Supreme Court of the Russian Federation. And since higher courts do not specify the limits of the administrative bodies and their actions, I would like to give a couple of examples saying how motives and goals are not taken. Last summer, the Court of Sibai said that administrative bodies cannot quickly inform, or should not quickly inform, the citizens about the state and the environment. And the court stated that according to the rules of procedure of Rospotrebnadzor, it is stipulated that it is responsible for informing the citizens only within 24 hours. And the High Court of the Republic of Bashkortostan did not take into account the importance of one aspect, the importance of this information, not only for the administrative body, but also for the citizens, knowing the information about the state of the environment is crucial for people. One more example is linked to the St. Petersburg law on administrative responsibility. It shows that a local administration might be legally responsible according to the budget law. The fines imposed within the framework of offense related to the construction sphere are transferred to the local budget. It means that local administration pays the fine to itself. Thus, it means that the subjects are chosen incorrectly. And most importantly, when local administration disputes such settlements in courts, the courts do not take this aspect into consideration. This concludes the presentation. I'm ready to answer the questions. Thank you very much. Are there any questions to the applicant concerning the presentation? I remind you that the question should be related to what we heard in the presentation and to the thesis itself. Since we don't have many people present in here, then I will address my question to the members of the Dissertation Council and to the Scientific Advisor. If there are no questions, as far as I understand, the members of the Dissertation Council have questions and they will have the opportunity to voice them. Then let we move to the next part, the speeches of the members of the Dissertation Council and the appraisal of the Dissertation Council, or questions and suggestions. Before we move to that part, I would like to ask you about your preferences. How are you planning to answer the questions and remarks by the members of the Dissertation Council? which can be found in the written reviews? Will you provide answers to each review in order, or would you like to give a generalized response to all of them? I would prefer to provide answers to all the reviews after they're voiced. Right? I'm not asking the members of the Dissertation Council, since this is your right. So we accept the following rule of procedure. Before we move to the speeches of the members of the Dissertation Council, I need to voice the reviews that we received from the online broadcast. The first review is from Zhernova. Associate Professor of Information Protection of South Uralskog State University. It mostly has complimentary estimation of the work done, practical value and novelty of the dissertation are pointed out. But I would like to pay my attention to the remarks. Firstly, the social context of the Russian states and the scientific approach talk about the distinguishment and separation of administrative procedures into certain spheres. Monitoring, public service, and putting to justice. The applicant regrets that there is no unified legal act in administrative procedure. Thus, the author says that there is a lack of a specified unified mechanism of implementation of the right to pre-trial proceedings. Taking into account French experience, I would like the author to specify and formulate the approach to regulating basic stipulation of administrative procedures. Should it be the act only applied to the judicial powers and the executive powers? Then, talking about the process of implementation, information technology, and digitalization. Year 2020 led to the fact that maybe many private actors and power body had to move into virtual space within the judicial proceedings. And there are cases of using search information systems as my arbitrator, Skype, and even WhatsApp. But this has an exceptional character of the measures taken, and they have to be considered in the context of the right to protect or the right to the access, the right to be defended or the right to access the court or administrative body considering the dispute. Nevertheless, all the above-mentioned remarks do not underestimate the importance of the thesis. We also got the review from Pierre Suren, and it is provided in English. So, dear colleagues, members of the Dissertation Council, I have to voice the critical remarks of the review. Nevertheless, the review says that taking everything above mentioned into account, the author of the review considers that the applicant should be awarded the degree of the candidate of sciences, and the thesis are well documented. So what are the remarks voiced by research to Rome.
According to which the government has the ability to impose demands of their subjects, does he think that administrative citizens are subjects of state rather than subjects of the law? The author seems also to point out trends to a development of pretrial. Does he think that pretrial appeal can be a better way to prevent or resolve court cases? Could not it be the exact contrary? Elsewhere, Mr. Kuryndin quotes Articles 41.1 of the Chapter of Fundamental Rights of the European Union as the text that gives a general outline of the right to good government, and that holds a specific place in the development of the legal system of the EU and its member states. But as we know, the Court of Justice of the UE can't be easily seized by individual people, unlike the European Court of the Human Rights. How we can consider that this charter develops the legal systems of the member states of the European Union without an EU court to protect it and to impose its provisions to administrative authorities. Moreover, in the last chapter, the author seems to admire the fact that the procedure that guides pretrial actions before administrative authorities or before courts is fixed by courts themselves. However, that way to make the procedural rules and can be considered as problematic in some way for some people, because in a state system founded on democracy, the power that makes law should normally be different or the one of who interprets and applies that law. This is exactly the sense of fundamental principle of separation of power. Considering this, how can the author convince the ones who don't agree with the idea according which this is the judge that makes the procedural rules guiding the pretrial action? Ну вот замечание на английском языке. Дальше, как мы договорились, вы пока не отвечаете на эти замечания. И
I've agreed that you do not provide answers to the questions yet, and we move on to the speeches by the members of the Dissertation Council. Since all the reviews were published on the St. Petersburg State University website, I offer all the members of the Dissertation Council to speak only about the key points of their reviews, and I hope that nobody opposes to this idea. As far as I can see, there are no objections. If Pavel Astafyevich is not against, we will give the floor first to the members of the Dissertation Council in the remote mode. So we start with those who are present in the remote access mode, and I would like to give the floor to Grigory Vasilevich, who is the member of the Dissertation Council, represents the Republic of Belarus, the Doctor of Law, the head of the Department of Belarus State University. Dear participants of the meeting, I highly estimate the thesis by Pavel Kuryndin. The topic is rather important, and the research itself is full of novelty. From the point of view of providing information and the analysis of information and talking about the practical approach. it is of importance that comparative analysis was conducted. Using French experience as the role model. Stated that the thesis is dedicated to a specific issue, but the plan includes the implementation of the right to good governance. Traditionally, this aspect is often considered, but in this research, this approach allows to combine theory and practice, which improves the content and gives additional information on the approach of the author. There is a balanced approach to the research, which allowed to provide the comprehensive analysis of the relationship between with the pre-trial appeal, action and inaction of administrative bodies, which is of high importance as well. In my opinion, the author was able to show the general and specific aspect of Russian and French judicial practice. The definitions are of quality, although some of them are well known, but the author provided a personalized view, and some of the terms were considered in such light. Such terms as administrative act, principles of law, and this all show an innovative approach, a pre-trial appeal. If we talk about Belarus practice, we rarely use such a way as pre-trial appeal. I am for preliminary procedures, although we are able to provide pre-trial appeal or pre-trial dispute. I consider that the applicant solves a very important state task of eliminating disputes. One of the Russian scientists, Tikhomirova, talks about conflictology and the ways to avoid disputes. And I think that this thesis is in the framework of the situation in the Russian Federation. Also, there is a differentiation between a dispute and pre-trial disputes, which allows not to intervene different procedures of settling the disputes. This work on strengthening constitutionality of the protection of freedoms and rights. I highly praise the way how the author regards the institutionalized system in France and its pre-court defense. Much attention is paid to Russian and Belarus scientific literature and the State Council of France as well. The author in here, within the context of the topic, paid attention to the most important aspect. I can share the point of view of the author based on the French experience. The right to pre-trial appeal might be applied to the disputes sent as letters and telegrams addressed to administrative bodies. Earlier we had wide practice, but now it is a bit narrower, but it is still preserved when important issues might be solved via letters or telegrams or any other published materials which cannot formulate it in adequately. The decision of such a sort, such documents, can be disputed pre-trial and via court proceedings. I also wanted to note that taking into account the judicial link between pre-trial and court proceedings, pre-trial proceedings in order to solve certain dishes cannot be the goal in itself. Authorities will not solve the legitimacy issue if their quality of the work of administrative bodies not increased. Such a thing as red tape can be still found, and we should take into consideration the way public officials work and which steps they take to tackle the applications from citizens. The procedural aspects in pre-trial and court proceedings are also taken into account, and the specific traits of pre-trial proceedings acts taken as a result of the litigation. In this context, the principles of the legislation are also often avoided, which should serve as the base of the action taken. My general idea is that the thesis by Pavel Kuryndin has an important impact on the pretrial appeal of action and inaction decision of administrative bodies. The author of the thesis provided a lot of interesting solutions on improving the effectiveness of legal regulations. The tasks and targets set in the thesis were successfully resolved. At the same time, I paid attention, maybe the applicant will ponder on this issue. But in the context of these problems, we could talk about such an important thing as administrative precedent. Usually we hear about court precedents, which is a very important source of law, and I think that court precedent has to be fixated and has to be specified in the theory, at least. Taken into account that thanks to that, we provide the right of each citizen to equality in the face of law and court. And in this case, administrative precedent is aimed at the same point, that is the provision of everyone in the face of law and administrative body. This topic is rather important and interesting. And using information technology, which are more and more used in court proceedings, can be implemented on the territory of such a great country as the Russian Federation and the territory of Belarus. On the whole, I think that the thesis by the applicant corresponds to the requirements set by the regulation of St. Petersburg State University, and the applicant deserves being awarded the scientific degree of legal sciences. Thank you for your attention. Thank you very much, Grigory Vinitsky. As we have agreed, all the members of the Dissertation Council will provide their reviews, and I will give the floor to Andrei Vinitsky. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Can you hear me? Dear Sergei Dmitrievich, dear members of the Dissertation Council, everybody present, I would like to say that I have an overall positive view of the thesis. If we talk about its novelty, I would like to say that it is expedient and from the point of view of subjective individual rights of private actors is used, and the methodology of subjective public rights might improve the legal position of and balance the relationship of unequal subjects of the state. And as the candidate notes, pre-trial appeal of administrative acts is a means of protection of subjective public rights of individuals. within the framework of the Soviet influence of legal school and the doctrine of subjective individual rights, and the research in this sphere are very important and they should be welcomed. And the applicant, considering the Russian judicial methodology, remembers that he is taking point of view of protection of private rights into consideration. What is more, this thesis is in line with the problems of administrative procedure. Progressive sciences, science of administrative law for many years favors completion of development and adoption of several federal laws and administrative procedure. And specific elements of this future law should be considered, and the applicant provided information of pre-trial issues, a pre-trial dispute, which should be part of the bill that we are expecting. As for the usage of the main method of comparative judicial method, we can see the results quite clearly. The experience of France is of crucial importance, taking into consideration the code that was adopted in France, and it was only partly analyzed in Russian science, and the administrative legislation and European Union legislation are important, since we see the same problems in Russia and Eurasian Economic Union. Thus, it means that scientists and interested in the area and people interested in the issue should pay attention to this thesis. As for the general characteristics of the work, I'll try to be very concise because the majority of the provisions can be agreed upon. Why you can find in the written review in the public, which is published online, and then I'd like to move to the discursive part of the review, which might be of special interest. There are three questions. First is related to the division of administrative acts on burdensome and favorable. The information can be found on page 12. In here, we have certain questions. We know that this division is taken in the German legal doctrine. And later on, among the provisions of the thesis, is not used by the applicant. So this classification is not used by the applicant. The question arises, why was it mentioned in the provisions? Or is there a similar division in the French doctrine, legal doctrine, and law enforcement practice? And how does the applicant himself assess the degree of scientific novelty? This is not a formal question, but this is a question about the content, because this information about the classification allows us to differentiate administrative procedure and appeal administrative act. And the procedure of appealing burdensome and favorable acts should be different. And if we take into account the Russian experience, the respective chapters can be found in Russian laws on provision federal law of 2010, organization provision of state municipal service, federal law on the state control and municipal control in Russian Federation. So there is a division, because in one case this is the right to get subjective service from the state, then it is the law of non-interference or the law on administrative procedure. although I agree with the idea that these issues should be regulated within the framework administrative procedure, how should we take into account the specialization specifics that objectively exist? And the procedures of appeal of burdensome or favorable acts based on the experience of France. And this methodology of differentiation acts is important in practical approach. And the applicant pays specific attention to the right of administrative bodies to cancel their own enforcement decision, as well as normative act. When we talk about such an opportunity, there is no issue when we talk about burdensome acts. But if we are talking about a favorable act, then these issues are rather sensitive for private actors when we talk about the provision of areas, slots, or granting the construction opportunity. Thus, it might be a very sensitive issue. So methodology, which is based on differentiation of different acts, provides necessary answers. Then this methodology would have allowed the applicant to provide more clear summary about of the way to appeal against administrative acts for the purpose of resolution of the suspension acts of the contested decision. The potential of comparative legal method maybe was not used fully. For example, the topic raises of appeal against administrative contracts in France. And it is concluded that, according to the French documents, it can be done only in judicial procedure challenge. But there is no relevant analysis of Russian situation. Nevertheless, this is not an easy topic for a Russian legal system, since this institution is not legitimized, despite its presence in the appropriate legal structures. Pre-trial or court procedures, if we take, for example, Urban Planning Code of the Russian Federation, this comparative analysis would be interesting. And the second chapter, where the author mentions good governance, has a more descriptive character. It gives the general recipe on using the doctrine of good governance in Russia. Who should adopt this doctrine? Scientific community, executive branch of power. It would be better to have a more active approach to compare these two systems. And the doctrine of good governance exists in Russia, well, although it's not called this way. And the parallel structures could be done more in depth. And the third minor remark relates to the use of statistics, because it's sometimes used only fragmentary, especially when the example of 2012, why exactly was this time period justified, then statistic for 2013. So it is not argumented why statistics is provided for this particular time. And as for statistics, considering the Russian Federation, not always is the chronology maintained. But these are minor remarks. And the most important thing is that the remarks are of discursive aspect and they stress the novelty of the topic. And I would like to emphasize that they do not discredit the thesis. And the research is the work which is worth awarding the degree of candidate of legal sciences. And the personal influence on the scientific discussion of the issues of the in the legal sphere. And the main provisions were seen in the publications indicated in many journals. In accordance with the regulation on from the 1st of September 2016, the applicant deserved to be awarded the academic degree in the major 12014. Thank you for your attention. Thank you, Andrei Vladimirovich. And we move on. And I would like to give the floor to Elvira Talapina, the Doctor of Law Sciences, who represents the Institute in the Russian Academy of Sciences. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. I would also like to be very concise in my report. I would like to say that whenever we view the issue of cooperation of administrative bodies and citizens will always be important. And when we conduct comparative analysis with such a classic administrative state as France, it always plays a very important role. One of the major advantages of this thesis is it could list of reference, especially books and reference material in French, which means that the applicant worked in depth on comparing the French legal system. I would also like to note that a good turn was to use the formation of the research, starting from the concept of good governance, which improves the scientific approach and is beneficial for practical application. To think how our state governance should look like. And I would like now to move on to remarks and issues for discussion. And I'm sure that the applicant will provide answers to these remarks. So firstly, related to the concept of good governance, my first question, so to say, is the following, or first remark is the following. Many times, in the presentation and in the thesis, administrative procedures are mentioned and the necessity to adopt federal law or any kind of law. And I would like to say that starting from 2000s, there have been many projects made as initiative projects by different scientists. But the situation hasn't changed so much. But in here, I would like to say about different sphere. Administrative procedures are based around a formal element, so to say, of state governance as the necessity to comply with a specific set of actions with achieving a specific result. And authoritative bodies put these administrative procedures into administrative rules of procedure. It is highly formalized. And when everything's highly formalized, the essence is often missed. In this respect, it seemed to me that regulating the actions of providing state governance should be conducted on a larger scale, using a larger normative base, using the laws on the basis of state governance. Thus, saying whether state government should be considered according to the doctrine of good governance, efficient, and so on. So my remark is about the attitude of the applicant, because this is not mentioned in the thesis itself. And I'm sure that the applicant himself has a point of view. Is it enough to use the legislation only in the administrative procedure, and we have different administrative regulations which substituted administrative procedures? Or should we talk about a broader regulation, a regulation in a broader sense, and try to promote the idea of the law on state governance? The second aspect that I would like to pay attention to is the appeal of acts in the forms of letters and telegrams. I suppose it will be supported by everybody, but I want to pay attention to the following idea, the analogy with the French doctrine of implicit decisions. In my opinion, this practice does not fully comply with the Russian practice because of the following situation. Thanks to great formalization of administrative procedures, it's very difficult to imagine the situation when an administrative body does not give a response on your filing, because they have to provide a response. The response itself might be only formal and not having much information, relevant information, but Russian administrative bodies are to provide a reply. If we talk about French administration, they have a different approach. They do not have the regulations and norms which are binding in terms of timing. And it is very typical when an administrative body does not provide any response to the filing of the citizen. In this respect, there was the concept of implicit decisions emerged, according to which the citizen could understand the implications of the decision taken. And I think these two ideas of using this concept cannot be compared due to the difference of the situation in our countries. The next issue that I would like to note in terms of discussion, on pages 113-114, the applicant talks about the appraisal of expediency of taken administrative acts. And the applicant says that such practice is limited in France as well. In Germany, it is also limited as well. Few countries provide administrative courts with the possibility to take decisions. In this respect, I would like the applicant to say about the possibility of implementation in Russian administrative practice and maybe expansion of court competence, the possibility of appraisal of expediency of the acts, with the lack of the law regulating the state governance as such. And finally, the aspect that was given, specified in the presentation about the separation of power, judicial, executive powers, and balancing the French doctrine about not intervening of judicial and executive powers. And I think that the applicant favors the idea of not intervening of these aspects of power. But I would like to remind you that in France, the historic background of the State Council provides for certain intervening of these powers. So it might have dual functions. It has not only judicial powers, but it provides consultation to the government before major decisions and normative acts are adopted. So there is this intertwining in France. And I think that a new view, a new approach on the theory of separation of powers might be expressed. And very often we can hear the idea that this tradition is old-fashioned. And the final remark, as far as I understood when I read the thesis, that Russia has no hope of creating a full-scale administrative justice in Russia in the form of separate administrative courts, despite the use of the French doctrine, where it serves as a key idea that the courts should not intertwine and the separation has to be done. So in this respect, I would like the applicant to specify the position. Is there such a hope or perspective? Maybe in future research, this idea will be expanded upon, the idea of full-scale administrative justice in Russia with the adequate development of material norms. As you might have understood, mostly my remarks are of discussion, discursive aspect to stimulate discussion, but they show that the thesis is of scientific importance. There is work to discuss. There is ground for discussion. This is an impact in the development of science of administrative law, and I'm sure that the applicant deserve to be awarded the scientific degree on legal sciences. Major 12014, since the research itself and the presentation of the thesis complies to all the requirements. Thank you for your attention. Thank you, Elvira Vladimirovna. And we move on. And now I would like to give the floor to Vladimir Yurkov, Doctor of Law Sciences, Professor, the head of the Department of Tate Law School in Sverdlovsk. Dear colleagues, can you hear me well? Yes, we can hear you well, thank you. Dear Sergei Dmitrievich, Sergei Aleksandrovich, dear colleagues. Well, first of all, I would like to thank you all for this opportunity to participate in the committee. I would like to thank you, Elena Vladimirovna, with such an interesting work, which is very interesting. I won't say the same things that have been voiced before. It is worth noting that Sergei Aleksandrovich addressed the issues of comparative analysis in terms of France, because for many years, we with Elvira Vladimirovna haven't seen each other for 10 years. Thanks to this defense, we can see each other. What I like about the French is that they think that they have not only the best wine, the best fashion, but they have the best legal law. And everything else which is best in the world, everything else linked to the and the right might be differentiated into private and public. And dear colleagues, I will have to view this topic from the point of view of procedural law. And as for the procedural law, the topic raised by the applicant is important not only for the science of administrative law, but for the civil law and arbitration law. From the point of view of the process, it is an eternal topic, the decrease of the load of the court. And these pretrial procedures, from the point of view of procedural law, are ways of pretrial settlement, and it helps to provide court control and thus lightening the burden of the courts. This issue has a long story. I was able to get to know all the constitutions, constitutional law starting from 1936, but according to the Constitution of 77, there was Article 58, which said that the citizens cannot dispute the action of administrative authorities. And professors Savinsky and others wrote articles about the right of citizens. And they talked about the concept of judicial romanticism, and everything might be taken to court. Everything might be appealed in court. The position of our department was more cautious, and we always said that pre-trial procedure is required. Not everything can be taken into court because the court system might not be able to deal with that. And after the declaration of state sovereignty of state federation, the judicial romanticism was ungrounded, and there was legal collapse because the court could not process the number of cases that it received. And higher courts and the doctrine itself stipulated for the idea of considering the disputes pre-trial proceedings. And Pavel Aleksandrovich talks about it from the point of view science of administrative law. And there are many interesting aspects that I noted while reading the thesis. And you can get this information in detail in my review. Pavel Aleksandrovich writes about the good governance doctrine and the service state doctrine, which is related not only to administrative law. It might be discussed in the executive procedure. We had the Northern Congress on executional proceedings, and that was a Francophone organization of the bailiff department, and they discussed the issue of good governance in the sphere, which we use in the judicial sphere, not only in the executive sphere, because it is not often viewed as positive, because court is considered as a special structure in our culture. In my opinion, the thesis is well grounded. I would only pay attention to the two issues that might be discussed. And the first issue is Pavel Aleksandrovich and many other colleagues said that there is a necessity to adopt a general normative act in administrative procedures where the issues of pre-trial settlement could be discussed. There should be provided more guarantees, getting to know the materials, the ability to be heard, get the evidence, receive the motives. Well, I agree with all these provisions, but the question is about the following. What are, according to the applicant, the limits and the level of the regulation of pre-court proceedings? Because they might be complicated by the elements of the classic court procedure. What should be the minimal standards when we consider that we are provided with fair trial, with the idea of guarantees and pre-trial appeal? Excessive complexity and the desired increased level of the guarantees might lead to the fact that we thus make the procedure extremely complex. We increase the price for the citizens and for the state, and thus it might result in the decrease of efficiency. Sometimes it is the case with the tertiary litigation. If we talk about arbitrary litigation, some of the complexities are the things of the past. The execution of legal orders, in if we follow the simplified litigation process, is more difficult than the pre-trial procedure before that. So the court procedure itself might be more complicated than the pre-trial proceeding. Thus, the complexity increased from level to level. The second issue is related to the second, to the following idea. A unified normative act on administrative procedures of pre-trial appeals. Many federal laws stipulate for specific bodies of executive power, which has the high level of dispute, the special approach to appealing, to settling disputes. If we take our law on executive orders, there is Chapter 18, which has detailed analysis of the rules of procedure. So this judicial model of a pre-court appeal, should it be related to all types of a pre-court or pre-trial procedures, or not take into account those which have their specified rules and regulations, such as taxation law and others? Maybe there is no necessity to unificate and provide absolute similarity of all the structures. These are issues to discuss, since if it is a real research work, it should stimulate the reader to pose certain questions, and this shows that this is a true research work which can be characterized by relevance and novelty. I suppose that the thesis corresponds to the major 120014. In our way, it is in compliance even with our major 120015, and the applicant deserves to be awarded the scientific degree of a candidate of legal sciences. We have listened to the reviews of all the members of the Dissertation Council who are in remote access mode. Thus, we can give the floor to Pavel Aleksandrovich Astafichev, who represents the State University of the Department of Constitutional International Law. Good afternoon, dear colleagues, the members of the meeting. Well, I'll try to be concise because you can find the detailed review published online. I would like to expand on the idea expressed by Grigory Alexeyevich that the thesis by Pavel Aleksandrovich is definitely within the framework of the majority 12014, and this is out of the question, but also it has a very interesting constitutional ground. I mean Article 33 of the Constitution about the implementation of subjective right, and I mean Article 45 of the Constitution, which stipulates for the forms of the protection of our constitutional rights and freedoms. And from this point of view, the pre-trial institution has a logical similarities with constitutional law. And sixth article of the Constitution, concerning the rights and freedoms of the citizens, can have a logical similarity with the thesis, which also talks about not only administrative appeal but pretrial appeal. The author says that this institution serves as the protection of rights and freedoms of citizens, avoiding the dispute of such categories as defense, implementation, and enforcement. These terms are used in Articles 45 and 46 of the Constitution. It is of importance that the comparative analysis of Russian and French administrative legal experience is conducted, taking into account specific traits of the legal state of France is its multi-levels, and the summaries and the terms are considering the aspects of the notions stated in the research and talks about specific character. The ideas concerning the systematization and classification of the principles are of importance. And the specific principles, the principle of procedural economy and competence. Dear colleagues, members of the Dissertation Council talked about the good governance concept. I like the term good government. It is a very clear term which shows the relationship within the implementation of the legal norms. In my opinion, it is the way the applicant talks about the pre-court and court appeal procedures are compared in terms of the limitations of the freedoms and rights, in terms of time limitations. And the limitations might also include the prohibition to publish foreign works, to the intervention of police departments. On the whole, the applicant managed to talk about the applicability of French experience in Russia, to find the legal guarantees provided to private actors within the framework of pre-trial appeal, and provide definition to certain concepts and notions. I didn't specify any remarks in my officially published review. This is my point of view, but since we need to discuss what also took part within the process of the presentation. Since it was not specified in the dissertation, in the thesis itself, but in the presentation, there was this inaccuracy, and I would like to pay attention to that as a critical remark and possibly as a point for discussion. What I mean, at the very end of the presentation, when Pavel Aleksandrovich talked about the experience of using the experience in St. Petersburg, the term local was used. And local is not accurate, not from only constitutional point of view, but from judicial point of view. St. Petersburg, as well as other federal cities, the city itself does not have the status of municipal unit, not even the regions have the status of municipal units. In St. Petersburg, these are municipal regions. And if we talk about the legislations of the subject of the Russian Federation, we should avoid the usage of the word local, since it is associated with the synonymous municipal term and the federal law 133 on self-government in the Russian Federation stipulates for it. But this is a minor remark, and the thesis corresponds to the requirements, and the applicant deserves to be awarded the degree of the candidate of legal scientist, major 12014. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. From all the members of the Dissertation Council, I'm the only one to speak, and I'm to speak about the resolution and what my colleagues said before me means that I won't speak that much on the relevance and the novelty of the work and the specific traits of the novelty. And I would like to pay attention to two aspects amongst the provisions for defense. Pavel Aleksandrovich states that it would be of great use to regulate the procedure of pretrial appeal, taking into account the defense of private actors' rights, and to provide quasi-court guarantees, the right to be heard, the right to use the service of the lawyer, and it has a fragmentary stipulation in the legislation, but we cannot say that this is a universal measure, cannot be stated. But the ideas, according to Pavel Aleksandrovich, are quite interesting. I would also like to note, talking about the positive aspects of the thesis, that one of the key aspects is the way the material is provided. I easily grasped the concept and terms expressed by the applicant. The language used is highly adequate, and even very difficult specific moments are provided in such a way that even if you disagree with certain ideas, you feel that the author is not trying to give the wrong idea on the aspect on the issue. Well, taking into account the fact that we are pressed for time, I would like to talk about a certain points for discussion and the discursive aspect of the work shows that this is a true research work, and it that the presentation is actually the defense, because if there are no questions, then nothing can be defended. As for my remarks, first of all, I would like to ponder upon the idea that are often moving away from the balance of combination of Russian and foreign aspects leads to the fact that the applicant mixes the positive and negative aspects of the legal matter. It seemed to me that excessive favoritism of French experience led to the disproportion in covering the issues covered, which might be not in full compliance with the comparativist approach of the work. And in the name of the work, we have Russian in the first place and French in the second, France in the second. But if we turn about the contest, France is more expanded upon. Several categories, such as pretrial, appeal, administrative body, and administrative dispute, were not fully disclosed. And Descartes said that the humankind could have avoided half of its problems had they agreed on the meaning of words. For legal sciences, for the doctrine of legal sciences, as well as for any other science, it is very important to define the terms and categories. And if the author addresses such aspects, then they show the major part of the thesis. They should be specified and defined in the very outset of the work, especially if they are not comprehensively defined in the legislation. So the terms that I have mentioned are among such terms. In my opinion, they required a more specific definition. On page 22, the applicant says that administrative dispute, as one of the base categories of dissertation, is a legal conflict between the subjects of administrative law linked to the protection of rights and freedoms of private actors when implementing the rights of administrative bodies. It is a personalized approach and concept, but it is difficult to grasp what is an administrative body from this definition, and thus to understand what might the administrative disputes include. So certain information on administrative bodies can be found from author mentioning taxation bodies, customs bodies, registration bodies, and others. Nevertheless, the applicant did not provide the classification of bodies, but did not even give the list of such bodies, which, in my opinion, could be important for this thesis. The author focuses on positive aspects of pretrial appeal, and it is quite understandable since this is the topic of the thesis. But I would like to say that the research on the pretrial dispute could be even more comprehensive if certain limitations of the institutions could be taken into account. It is well known that the legislation on election and referendum eliminates the opportunity to discuss certain disputes in pretrial mode. And if the rejection of getting the right to conduct a public event does it require a pre-court proceedings, or it can be resolved only in the court? So the applicant should compare the pre-trial and court proceedings of appeal, focus attention on these aspects, and determine the limitations of pre-court appeal and the regulation of the Constitutional Court of the Russian Federation from the 4th of March 2020, number 12P, which stipulated then a pre-trial and non-court appeal has reasonable limitations. Not always its benefits and positive points allowed to be used a pre-court. Nevertheless, the above mentioned remarks are linked to the discursive manner of many issues discussed in the thesis and the ideas expressed by the applicant. On the whole, just like the other colleagues, I did not have any doubts that the dissertation fully complies with all the requirements for the thesis, and the applicant himself deserved to be awarded the scientific degree of for the candidate of legal sciences according to the order of the requirement on awarding the degrees. It is and the provision 11 is not violated. It means that novelty and applicability can be found. I think now, Pavel Aleksandrovich, you have heard all the remarks, and now the floor is yours. In accordance with the procedure, you may provide answers to the comments voiced by the members of the council. Dear colleagues, thank you very much for your interest in this study. I thank you very much for the comments and questions and suggestions. I will try to take into account all the methodological aspects that have been mentioned. As for the remarks of the discursive manner, they provided ground for a thought, food for thought, and expansion on certain aspects. Within the framework of my presentation, I tried to provide answers to some of the remarks, and I now created four groups of all the remarks. So firstly, as for the first provision concerning the Unified Law Administrative Procedures, in reality, the situation is such that full details of administrative procedures of provision of state municipal service or monitoring service, there is difference in terms, but each law has the list of single principles. It leads to the fact that administrative bodies might mix the approach to pre-trial proceeding. In my thesis, the taxation procedure took into account the dispute by administrative bodies, so there was a mixture of the procedure in here and intertwining of the procedure. What can be the form of the regulation? This will be a step to state governance as a whole, and the guarantees provided by the good governance doctrine should be included, and some of them can already be found in the law, such as the right to get additional evidence, which is provided by the federal law on competition. But this is only one law, but not a general rule. If we talk in general, then the rule on administrative procedures should define the idea of administrative act, the concept act, the status of the subject involved in pretrial appeal, provisions of the rights and obligations of the parties of the disputes, provisions of appeals evidentiary law, and consequences of violation of procedures. And I'd like to ponder upon some of the aspects in more detail. I used the code on the regulation of relationship between the population and the administration of France, and this code says that based on that, administrative bodies include the president, the council of ministers, and bodies which do not form the part of executive branch but ensure the activities of legislative and judicial institution, as well as decentralized administration bodies, in particular region, the department, community departments. They might serve as an administrative body and may be entitled to public functions. Thus, physical features of the concept are include the implementation of the management powers. The same can be found in the interpretation of administrative body, can be found in the Russian court. So there are three categories of administrative bodies, which provide a monitoring activity, which provide public service, or put to justice. Moving on to further aspects which I would like to ponder upon, from the point of view of administrative act, if it is considered according to the code of conduct between the citizens and administration, it has the classification and about burdening and favoring acts. If we talk about burdening acts, imposing sanctions, refusal, restrictions, then private actors, according to the code, should get not only the decision but the motives or reasons for its adoption. And the code went even further and used such a category as acts which cannot be found as regulatory or individual acts. These are neither regulatory nor individual acts. That might be the protocol of competition, decision to withdraw real estate, to establish any restriction on its use. These acts can be applied repeatedly and sometimes only once. For example, when the winner is retired or the owner changes. Taking into account such a differentiation, the code and the regulation of relation between the population and administration defines various rules of cancellation or revocation of administrative acts. Detailed regulation should be welcomed since it allows them to take into account the nature of the existing relationship in the proceeding. In this concept, the concept of burdensome and favorable acts in the framework of the pretrial appeal is important from the point of view of legal certainty and revision of original decisions if they were already executed. Along with this, in which way should administrative bodies review the dispute? How is the final decision taken? The code of final decision between administration and the individuals stipulates four meetings, especially if we talk about a burdening act. According to the Russian legislation, there are no such requirements for the meetings, and there are minor exceptions. For example, the appeal committee under the territorial bodies of Russian cadastre. In here, we can have a limited sphere, and the expert opinions and the statistics show that only in 5% of the cases can the applicants restitute their rights. but when we have millions of disputes, it means that within the period of functioning of appeal committees, only 26,000 of appeals were considered. It means that the institution doesn't work, and the regulatory function is such that the regulatory body might create a quasi-meeting, quasi-session, such as a decision to ask for documents. The norm itself hasn't been yet implemented, and there are no regulations about the specific types of control. The second group of questions is linked to the role of pretrial appeal in increasing the level of protection of rights and freedoms, as well as reducing the judicial burden. The Constitutional Court and the resolution of the 24th of March last year once again reiterated the problem in the opposition of pretrial appeal and judicial protection. It turns out that formally, individuals can file a complaint with administrative authorities, but in case of an unfavorable outcome, the judicial authorities refuse protection due to missing the deadline for filing an application without even taking into account the essence of the issue. According to the regulation of November 26, 2019, number 49, on issues arising judicial protection in contention with entry into force of the Customs Code of the Eurasian Economic Union, the limitation of pretrial appeal is suspended. Thus, it provides constant appeal, the condition for efficient protection of rights and freedoms of private entities. If we talk about the political rights, if we talk about the constitutional law, additional research is required, depending on the body taking decision concerning the dispute. The legislator is not always coherent in defining the subject of pretrial appeal. In the law on provision of municipal service, there is a chapter dedicated to appeal. It is limited to procedural aspects, so it has a shortened aspect. In this respect, I would like to express my agreement with the position of providing an open list of grounds for appeal. Administrative bodies are not only competent, are not competent in each sphere, and they can determine expediency and the necessity. And the list of such provisions should be reinforced with increasing the powers of administrative bodies, since altogether it allows to estimate how was the decision taken, whether it was grounded, were there any procedural violations, and how did they influence the final decision. Thus, we go back to the discussion where a private actor influences the final decision. And finally, I would like to give a little bit of the statistics. According to 2020, our judicial system was overloaded. For example, arbitrary courts considered 25 million of disputes. And the number of companies that we have are 3 million. In Britain, for example, this figure is about 100 per year, although there are 4.2 million companies. It means that courts have the opportunity to get to the essence of the case and to provide the motivated decision. The third group of issues is linked to organization of pretrial appeals and administrative procedures. The feedback received raised the questions of the used information technology. If we talk about pretrial procedures and court procedures, I would like to point out that IT should be considered as a measure to create governmental governance, because they facilitate the procedure. If we get in depth into the topic, then according to the science, only demonetization of the judicial proceeding is under discussion currently, and no attention is paid to predictive or prognostic analytics when based on certain algorithm and using certain data we might get the settlement, which might be of advisory nature, for example, but the individual actor might know what to expect, and this is the target of law, to predict and to estimate the consequences. Pandemics also exposed the unreadiness of the judicial bodies to demonetization of the proceeding. The arbitrary courts did better than general jurisdiction courts, for example, or administrative dispute courts. After the limiting measures were lifted, were almost blocked. Now the applicants are waiting for the settlement for 5 or 6 months. From the point of view of the efficiency of court protection, it is rather disputable. The practice of Federal Anti-Monopoly Service, which was imposed to send the appeal on a consideration without the personal approach, or to use the system which is used with the discussion with the central apparatus. Well, quite often this does not correspond to the legislation, for there are no direct grounds. But the main idea is that the defenders and the applicants often did not have the access to court, and the principles were different. Some did not have the technical equipment, then there were some technical problems, and the process itself was not conducted in accordance to the norms when witnesses did not provide information or not all the evidence was provided. I think we are in the very beginning of our road and much has to be discussed. Another way to improve the level of protectiveness of personal actors is the implementation of administrative precedent. In my thesis, I talked about the practice of a quality definition of different legal aspects allow the lawmakers to decrease the number of cases sent to court 3 times. And the role of precedent in Russia is so high, since our legislation is not comprehensive and have clear definitions. And precedent may be used in disputable issues. And the context of the usage of these administrative precedent is also important, since administrative bodies does not state that it refers us to a certain recommendation, it just follows the logic.
Скрытая угроза обеспечения равенства перед законом.
which serves as the threat to equality in the face of law. Because the applicant cannot appeal the decision of the higher institution. And the doctrine thus cannot help an individual actor because there is no definition and limitations of this theory. And the last group of the remarks are linked to the development of administrative law as such, and the role of the State Council in development and formation of French administrative law is great. But before, it served as an administrative body, and it was understood that courts can't consider administrative disputes. But later, it got judicial power, and now we have the Council of State, which is formally not a judicial institution.
Не имеет статус прямо предписанный, что.
And its members are not explicitly called judges, but they have the same guarantees. So this approach to the status limits its action, since it is more of a judicial institution, and the methodology that I mentioned in my thesis and my presentation are used. Thus, for France, there is no threat of confusion or intertwining of functions of judiciary and executive branches, since it is limited by the tradition and understanding of the role of the Council of State.
Другими словами, говорить о том, что это такое прочтение, такое конституционно-правовое наполнение принципа разделения властей.
In other words, this is the principle of separation of powers in France. And I'd like to make some more remark in this respect as well about the formation of specialized courts. I believe that we should not create a new structure, but we should improve the code of administrative litigation and differentiate the civil legislation and administrative legislation and court litigation. And I move to the last point. The opportunity to challenge administrative contract from the point of view of doctrine and administrative manner. I believe that in the practice of using civil law, the challenge in administrative context does not fully correspond to such contracts, since civil legal instruments make it possible to recognize a contract as null and void, for example. If we talk about a state and private partnership, we might use such a form as the possibility of non-usage of the contract because of specific situations, pandemics or any other limitations might serve as an example of non-usage or non-compliance with the terms of and timing of certain liabilities. Another form is linked to the usage of normative acts. It is often used in, if we talk about the rent or providing security of public place. So these issues are discussed in administrative legal theory. An administrative order fully corresponds to the goals and targets of administrative agreements. but authoritative bodies say that civic litigation is more appropriate for them, since the principle of it is competitiveness, and the parties have to prove what they are talking about. And this is where I finish answering the questions. Thank you for your attention. Thank you, Pavel Aleksandrovich. I hope that all the members of the Dissertation Council, I'm not talking about the content of the answers to the remarks, but are satisfied with the remarks of the applicant, and is there any need for any specific questions? No. Thank you very much. Now, within the work of the Dissertation Council, we didn't get any questions online through the website, so there is no need to voice any. Then we have the option for the scientific advisor to give the overall estimation of the work of the applicant, and maybe say something to the members of the Dissertation Council. Dear colleagues, I'm happy to see everybody. I would like to know that Pavel Aleksandrovich works on the topic of his research starting from 2013. Thus, he was able to look at the evolution of the institution in the Russian Federation within the course of his research through a lengthy and dynamic period for the institution. And thanks to his knowledge of the French language and trips to France, he was able to grasp the idea of the French administrative law and get to know the problems that are to be solved by Russian legislation in terms of pretrial appeal. You can find the in-depth description of my review on the website, so I'm not going to give all the details of my review. But I would like to say that this research was seriously scientifically approved. The applicant combined research with judicial practice, work with administrative bodies and judicial disputes. He provided the results of his scientific research on conferences and published scientific works, which received a positive appraisal from the members of scientific communities. A scientific project which I was heading also was a part of that, which was linked to the access to court defense in public rights. I consider that these thesis is relevant and has novelty, and that Pavel Aleksandrovich can be awarded the degree of the candidate of legal sciences. Thank you, esteemed Yelena Vladimirovna. Colleagues, now I'm addressing the members of the Dissertation Council. Now you have the opportunity, if something is not clear yet and has to be discussed, you need to say that. Well, I don't feel that there is a need for it, but I have to ask you the following question. Then we can move on. And according to the rules of procedure, we have the following. We are at a turning point. If the members of the Dissertation Council consider that we require before the roll call to have a couple of minutes of the discussion with muted sound, we can offer that. But in the course of the remarks, all the colleagues expressed their ideas, and there is no need, in my opinion, for such a discussion. Dear colleagues, what do you think? Do we need a break for discussion? No. Me neither. I don't think that there is necessity to have this break. Then we move to the next point in our rule of procedure, and I put the question of awarding Kuryndin Pavel Aleksandrovich scientific degree of the candidate of legal sciences on scientific major 1200 of 14 administrative law and administrative procedure. We start the open roll call. Before each member of the dissertation council expresses the opinion, I want to remind you that the decision on awarding the scientific degree is considered positive if at least if more than half of the members of the council and not least than three members of the dissertation council participating in the meeting voted for it, in according to clause 23 of the procedure. Since we have six people present, then we need four votes for the positive decision. Now, in the alphabetical order, I'm addressing you. And I would like you to express your opinion and express your point of view, whether you are for awarding the scientific degree or against it. Astafichev, Palaksanch, I vote for. Grigory Vasilievich, I vote for. Thank you, Grigory Vasilievich. Andrei Vinitsky, your opinion, thank you. I vote for. Elvira Talapina, I vote for. And Vladimir Yarkov, your I vote for. So the chairman votes for as well. Thus, out of six members of the dissertation council who participated in the voting procedure, the results are the following. Four voted. Six people against, no people abstained, no people. Thus, the dissertation council agrees to award to Kuryndin Pavel Aleksandrovich to the academic degree of candidate of legal sciences on major 1200-14 administrative law administrative procedure. The decision was taken unilaterally, without reservation. Before we give the final word to the applicant, taking into account the fact that some of the members of the dissertation council, I need to ask all the members of the dissertation council, are there any reservations of remarks on the procedure, I want to stress, of the meeting. The meeting was conducted perfectly by the chairman. Thank you. No remarks and no objections. There is one idea. In France, we participated in such a procedure. I want to say that our procedure is so formalized We should facilitate the procedure. So I recommend using French experience in terms of procedure. I agree with you, but I think this is a cultural or legal shock when 12 years ago, when I was the judge of the Constitutional Court, with all the respect to this body, the first thing that shocked me was that many aspects, with all their formalization and importance, were not so highly formalized by the judge and the chairperson. The motto is such, the rope has to be long and the speech short. I hope that we will give your idea to the Rectoral College, and further on it will be the work of the Dissertation Council improved. On behalf of the Dissertation Council, first I want to thank you colleagues for your work and for your responsible approach. And now I give the floor to the applicant for the final remarks. Dear members of the Dissertation Council, I want to thank you for your time and for detailed analysis of my work and for your precious remarks that will help me in my scientific work and professional work. And I would also like to thank the scientific community on the research of which I was able to conduct the research. The research paper is individual work, but it also requires the work of of other scientists. Yelena Vladimirovna was with me throughout a lengthy period of time and helped me to work on my thesis. Yelena Vladimirovna, thank you very much. I'm extremely grateful for all your work that you gave, your scientific authority and your knowledge in scientific area, and you partook it with me. I want to thank Natalia Alexandrovna Shevilova, the head of the department of St. Petersburg State University. When she was a graduate student, she helped me with the choice of this topic, and it turned out to be that following this road, this topic gets a new development because of the quick development of administrative reform. And Natalia Alexandrovna influenced the fact that I defend this research in my university. I would also like to thank the associate professor of Mitrek, who helped me with precious advice and comments, and was a secret advisor and reviewer at the same time. And I would like to thank the associate professor to Vyacheslav Savin, who gave who provided me with much help on the project. I would also like to thank the person who is linked to the comparative judicial research, and it wouldn't have existed if I did not have French language in my life. And I want to thank my teachers of the French language, and I would like to thank my teacher, Shendeva Lidia Alexandrovna, who gave me the basis for the French language and the love for the French language and French as a whole. So I'd like to thank my family, of course, who, thanks to the university, has the opportunity to view this broadcast, the result of my work. And I have great thanks for them, who stimulated me to work in this area. And I would like to thank my alma mater for the opportunity to be able to research such an interesting topic and to develop these ideas and to share my knowledge with the students when working on the Department of Administrative Financial Law. Thank you very much. Aleksandrovich, thank you very much. When you started thanking everybody, I thought that it was Friday and you would thank everybody, including all the people who worked for you, and it's great that you also thanked your family. I would like to congratulate you on being awarded the scientific degree, the academic degree of the candidate of legal sciences, and I want to say that you're the candidate for doctoral degree, and we hope that you have all the necessary traits for it. We congratulate you once again.
Трансляцию, да? Спасибо.